Hi all, today we can see how we can create a business partner in SAP S4HANA with easy steps. So please follow my the configuration so it is easier to you. You can do it. First you need to define the vendor account group and customer account group and member names. Now I'm going to define the vendor group first. T code is OBD2. Okay, first you define the customer account group, click new entry and give B200 customer for B100 run. So if you choose this in this is a one time account, okay, don't choose this one, just press and save, then go back and define the member range for customer EXDN1. Click here and interval choose this number ranges which are not available. Yeah, before we are going to create the member ranges. So for the vendor and customer, vendor and customer number and BP number should be if your the client is expecting the same, then we need to define the same member range for the vendor and customer, and BP number also we need to define same. Then only we will get both as a one number. If you are defining the different number, then BP number is different and your customer or vendor number will be different. So I will show you the configuration where you are going to make as a difference for this. Now I'm going to define the for the customer, and we need to define this number as a XML number. Plus, click on plus, then copy paste that number and choose this is an XML number. Okay, click save, go back. And assign the same number range to the created customer group. I created 200 customer group. I'm going to define A2. Click save. Now, in the same way, we need to create the number ranges for vendor account group and customer number ranges, and we need to assign. For vendor account group, OBD3, click here, click on new entry, give your vendor account group and vendors per soft. Press enter, click on save, continue save, click back, again back, one more, and click on XK enable number ranges. Click on the number ranges for vendor account. Click on interval, change interval. Copy the your number range. Click on plus button, insert, paste here. Now we can see here, we need to choose this is an XML because the customer expectation is BP number and the vendor number should be same. It should not be any difference, okay? Click on save. Click on back. Again back. Assign the number ranges for vendor. Our group is, vendor group is A1. Save. Okay, now we have done this part. Now we are coming to the BP configuration part. Okay, come to cross application component. Click on business partner. Then click on business partner. SAP business partner, then business partner, basic settings, then number ranges and groups. Okay, click here to define number ranges, then click on the number ranges. Here we need to define the number ranges for vendor and customer BP number ranges. So these are the number ranges which I have defined for BP number. Here don't choose as a XML, okay, because our BP number and vendor number should be same. That is the reason the in the account group, when we assign that number range, we have chosen as a XML. Press enter, save. Okay. Next, go to define grouping and assign number ranges. Here, you need to define our grouping. We will define our number. This is for the we can keep it as a domestic. Vendors per soft. The same way for the customer also. 200. So we have defined for that account group as a 200. The same thing we are defining here in this SAV. Domestic. Customer. Customer. For. Here, assign the number range which we have defined here. If you see here, we can see the number ranges A1 and A2. Our number ranges. Press enter and click on save button. Now it got saved. for synchronization purpose, okay, we need to go to master data synchronization. The same path, cross application, new component. Then master data synchronization. Then click on the vendor customer vendor integration. Then click on the business partner setting, then click on the setting for vendor integration. First we do the integration for the vendor, then we'll do for the integration for the customer, okay. Then click on the field assignment for vendor integration, then click on assign a keys, and here define number assignment for direction BP2 vendor. Whatever we have defined, we need to choose here. One sec. Okay. Yeah, so what we have to do, first we need to define the integration with we do first vendor, because we have defined like B100, B200, okay. Define number range assignment for the direction BP2 vendor, okay. Now here we define ours. Click new entry, define. And here choose the group. This is a vendor we are defining. Here we need to choose as a same number. DP number and vendor number should be same. Okay. Press enter. Save. And next path is the same path only. Define member assignment from previously we have defined BP to vendor. Now we are defining the direction vendor to BP. Click here. You need to choose our vendor group. Okay. Press enter. Save. The same way we need to define for the integration with customer. We have defined for the vendor. Then define the member assignment for direction BP2 customer. Click new entry. We need to choose our the customer group B200. And here also we need to choose as a account group is a, which is the account group we have chosen. We have defined that account group. We need to choose it. This is the B200. And we need to click it as a same member. If you don't click here, if you choose as a flexible, it means your number, BP number, and your customer number is different. So it won't be the same. Okay. Press enter. Hit save. Okay. Now we have done the direction BP2 customer. Now we are going to define member range assignment for direction customer to BP. We need to click new entry. We need to choose here our customer group. Here also we need to choose which is we have defined for the customer group. Press enter, save. Okay, but we done the synchronization from vendor to BP and BP to vendor and BP to customer, customer to BP synchronization we have done it. Okay, now we need to define the roles for our vendors and customers. Close this one, open, set the business partner. And click on business partner, basic settings, then business partner roles. Click on business partner. Here BP roles. Click on BP roles. SAP has provided the standard roles for the vendor and customer from for the FI perspective. Okay, choose these roles and make it according to your naming convention. Okay, now I'm going to choose this for this role and I'm going to make a change like this. SAP is provided FLV00 is the FI post, FI roles. FLVN00. Okay, this is for the vendor. Just choose this one and click on copy and change the current to your need. Now I'm going to keep here as a description. I will keep it for center, because SAP is provided the standard role, so we should not create the our own rules, because there are certain things which are it will be impact. So always we need to copy the standard role and we can make our according to our requirement. Then press enter, click on save. Now you see here. Okay, so all these are is assigned. Okay, now coming for this is for the vendor. Now we need for the suppliers. FLUC set a standard role. Yes, I will go up a little. Yeah, this is it. SAP provide for the finance the roles. Just choose this one and copy and make according to your convenience. I'm making as a B00MID and description and title also I'm making changes. why? Because I'm giving this description. So while I'm choosing the BP role, so it is easier to, when I choose this one, so along with this, so this the description will be appear. So I can easily identify the my roles which I have defined and which I have linked the account group for this. Okay, just press enter. Okay, now it's copied, save. Now we see creation of the vendor and customer. Go to slash n BP, click on organization, anything we can choose, whatever we have allowed in the BP roles, either person or organization or group. So it will allow. So for this standard is defined as a person, organization, group. So if the same roles is copied to my BP roles, okay. Now we can see here our BP role is reflected here or not. Yeah, now you see here, so I can easily identify that this is a my BP role which I have defined. Click create. Then we need to choose here the which is the account group we have linked for the synchronization. So I have defined as a B100, so I can see here. Okay, now BP role name, BP role, and this account group should be synchronized. Then only we could able to create the vendor. If it is a different, it we can't able to create. Okay, because it should be a get synchronization. That is the reason BP to vendor and vendor to BP direction synchronization we have done it. Now I'm giving you some company name, and just give the name, give some postal code, just give and country and language we need to give. Then click on save. Now the BP business partner number is created. Now I am going to extend to my company code. Okay, click on company code and give your company code B100. And click on company course. So it is not here. Click on adapt. So it is throwing that it is not available because just now we created. Now we are going to define it for the we are extend to our company code. What I do it again, I do it. Yes, okay. Just I will click on this one, adapt. Okay, now you can see here and give the your company code reconciliation GL account. Press enter. Now click on save. Yeah, this is just message only. So now if you see here your business partner number and your vendor number both are same. Why? Because we have defined here in the vendor group as external and BP member ranges we have defined as internal. So both that member in and the number and same number we need to tick that. If you don't do those things, if it is a selected as a flexible, I will show you. yeah, you can see here. If I don't choose here, if I don't choose here same number, then we can't, I can't able to create as a business partner number and vendor number should be same. Okay, now this is for the vendor we created. Now we will try to create for the customer slash and BP organization I have chosen, and click on organization. I need to choose the business partner BP role, which is belongs to . So this is my customer BP number. We need to choose the our account group. Here we are defining the here. Give some postal code. Give the country and give the language. Press enter. Click on save. You can click on save. Now BP partner number is created with the 82. Okay. Now you can click on, you need to extend to your company code. Click on your company code and click on change button, pencil button. Okay, give your company code B100. I want to do press enter. Now you can see here the other fields are enabled. So this reconciliation account is required. So I'm going to give this GL account for this. Press enter and save. I hope this video is helpful to you. Please come in and subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching the video.